Alright. Let's try these Japanese tracks out. Seven, that's fine. Let's try the roof for now. Oh, Bat Dad? I am the Bat Dad. Yeah. Nice. I don't play hockey games. I used to every now and then, but yeah, I mean those I played, Blades of Steel, that sort of thing. But play NBA Jam. They gave a date though. I thought it was like the 21st, isn't it? Yeah. I haven't gotten a key yet. Well, actually, I mean, it depends on the PlayStation Store team. Like when they get everything loaded and all that. You know, if they have these tracks in Japan, they need more Japanese cars now. Well, I'm sure they have different stages, you know, to test different things. Oh, man. Oh, shit. Yeah. I miss my bag. PlayStation now, bring it back. I just want to put a credit card in. What? Mag? No, they took them down a long time ago. That sucks. But then people saw the game for sale all over the place, still for like 10 bucks. I'm like, they're gonna buy a broken game because there's no single player whatsoever. You have to have the servers. No, I think the servers have to be up even for that. Nope. Holy shit, can't see. Sun's in my eyes. Oh, it's reverse. This one looks nuts, right? What can I do? So I'll see more of this. Oh, cool. Oh, we start in the tunnel. That's cool. This car corner is insane. This has become one of my favorite cars in the game. This Renault concept, like twin turbo concept car. It's ridiculous. It's like a Mini Cooper, but it's just insane, and the cornering is impeccable. Whoa! Until you get hit. Oh, you dick. Nice. Japanese tunnels, nice. See these in Gran Turismo. Oh shit! Couldn't see. Ah! Holy crap. That was awesome. Ooh, look at all these S-curves coming up. Oh my god. So take it to the limit. Well, you know. Wow, this car made those S-turns look like nothing. Come on. Ooh. Wow, I like this track. Wow. Ah, oh, let's crump this car in the top end. This is really bad. Oh shit, oh shit. Oh my god! Oh no, he's gonna pass me up! Right at the end, he passed me. Shit!
Hey, Irish Joe.
Play it in Rain. Well, I just want to learn the tracks first. I haven't played these yet. Then I'll do Rain. Lake Shoji. I'm gonna use the same car. I like this car. Yo. I'm just trying out the new tracks. Holy crap. Well, I like the look of this one so far. Holy shit. Well, I'm on the third track now. I like them so far. Really like them. No, because I'm playing single player right now. It's almost 6 gig. Yeah. Oh yeah, they said right away that they were going to bring out different regions. So I think the US is going to be on that list eventually. Oh shit. I think. But now that they have Japan tracks, I'd like to see more Japanese cars. That'd be really cool. Get the GTR in here. Yeah. Oh man, I like these tracks. Wow. They're just a lot more straightaways, that sort of thing, but like the last one I did had a series of S-turns, just one after another. Doing laps. Okay, so this is lap. Alright. Shit, overcompensated. I'm just gonna keep ramming the back of every car that's annoying. Oh shit! Ooh, I heard thunder. Oh, shit. Did not take that one well. Man, that car's got such high speed. Oh, my dick. Booyah! Yeah, stuff came out this morning. Mine took a while to download, though. It got really slow in the middle. It's out, G-Double. That's how I'm playing it.
I want to remove the flags. Those are what tells me what the turn might be. Oops. All right. So I did Shoji. All right. 2, 3. Okay, so this is another lap track. Yeah, so you can get rid of the crowd now. I don't know where you take the flags out, though. I don't see that, guys. Yeah, I'll take a different car. Oh, no.
Nice. That car almost scares me. Yeah, those only come in manual. They don't come in automatic at all. Oh yeah, they're pretty crazy, just how they engineered everything, and all the graphics were done by the folks at Polyphony. So on the center console, it was all done by the Gran Turismo folks. Yeah. High stuff. Oh, it is stuff. Oh shit. Daddy leaves! What a dick. Oh shit! Jeez. Did you go on Twitter and complain about that? Shit. Yeah, it's so difficult that my parents can even do it. Nice. All the thunder and everything, it's cool. No, it just downloads as a patch. Yeah, you might already have it. It's like a 5 gig patch. Mine went really fast up until 2 gig, and then all of a sudden it slowed way down, and then all of a sudden it sped way back up again. So I don't know. Yeah, then you already have it. I don't know what to tell you. That might be the cars, but the tracks are here. I don't know. Well, the cars probably won't go up until tomorrow. I have the tracks. That's what the patch put on. The new events and everything. That'll probably be tomorrow. I like these new tracks a lot. Crap. Hi there. Ugly. That's cool. All the cherry blossoms and everything. Ah! Oh shit! I'm all over the place! What an asshole. Oh crap. Yep, here's where the game punishes me. They did all the graphics and all of the stuff for the console on the Nissan GTR. Shit! Damn it. Ah. Oh my. Oh, this almost looks like a Suzuka style track. Scuderia. Expo. There's not that many cars on here that are good to take around a track like this. Yeah, I'll take the roof again. Yeah.
Corner penalty man.
This track is very Suzuka-ish, which is awesome. You're gonna like this one, Scott. Actually, I think you're gonna like all these. So far, they've been really good. Yeah, they even have the walkway over the track. That's awesome. Wish they've had a couple other tracks on that, but what is that? You trying the new track, or what are you playing? You don't? So if you go to single event, Japan's not in there. You have the patch. What the hell? That's weird how it works for me and not for you. Yeah, I'm only proving it by streaming. Yeah, so I turned the crowd off and it turns all the flags off too. So there's no extraneous stuff on here except for the HUD, which I can turn off too, I think. That I can do it maybe, but that's just not gonna happen. Sorry if I'm not looking at the chat bolts and concentrating. That's it. I know I need to respect my viewers more, but. Somebody said that because there were a couple people being douchey on that Evolve one. Yeah. They do? No, because we're not partners. People have like a ton of subscribers to do that. Crap! Yeah, but you are part of the Wolf Pack if you subscribe, so just remember that, folks. Arr! That exclusive club of everyone. Man, I just keep screwing that corner just a little bit. Jake, get on the road! Oh my god. Ah! Of course, I screwed up right toward the end of the race. God damn it! No, I screwed up and I went off the track and I couldn't get to recover well enough. Damn it. Oh yeah, I wish there was a rewind feature.
That actually would be nice.
Yeah, no kidding.
Yeah, they didn't invent that, so I don't give them credit for it. God, we did like a 2.5 hour podcast last night.
Really?
Yeah, we went in saying, what are we going to talk about? We have nothing to talk about, really. We said, well, we'll just talk about something. I did
what now? Yeah, that'll happen.
Yeah.
Have I seen the rainbows yet? No, because I haven't done any rain yet. I'm just trying to get on the tracks and do it dry, and then I'll do rain. Taste the rainbow. There's a double rainbow in this. I saw a picture this morning. Double rainbow!
They're always after me, Lucky Charms.
Let's try this one. We'll do the little Renault twin concept again. It's a fun little car. Although, with a lot of the straightaways on this track, it's going to suck to use it, but oh well. I really like this track. Scotland and Canada were my favorites for a long time, but these have a chance of becoming my new favorites. Scotland! You're racist! I'm from Scotland! I love this car, but the top speed sucks. This was probably the bad part too. Not talking about 153. Cornering penalty.
Drabbed.
I figured
Drabbed.
That was gonna happen. Oh shit. Crap. It's grabbed too much. Well, this is the Well, that's the problem. It's the top speed's not great, but the cornering is so amazing in this car. But there isn't a lot of cornering in this version of the track. Look at that.
We got a star.
Ooh. Oh crap. Just flies right down. Wow! Holy shit, did that grab. I didn't get a corner penalty? Wow.
Ooh. Hit that right. Right though, that Renault. Don't get on the rumble strips, because man.
Yeah, it's all over the place.
Yeah. Man, that roof just keeps catching right up to me and then it freaks out. Let me see if they can stop me and just drive the car doing that. You're like one of my only friends on Xbox Live that plays that game.
Always buy one of your car in there. It's funny, one time you were in a, it was an awesome car and you were in a Halo.
What?
Yeah.
Oh, he got me at the end. Damn it! And the chat room dies. Right.
Oh, so I'm not there anymore.
I'm gonna see if I have any new events then. You have the season pass for this, don't you, Stoff?
Yep. I bought it before the game even came out.
Oh yeah, so the events are saying coming soon, but I still have the tracks for single races. So if you go to single event and do race and everything, the Japan stuff's there.
Oh, single event, yeah.
Yeah, that's what I said. You were like, mm, I don't see him.
I never go on a single event.
Dynamic.
I just blame Vlad. It's easier that way.
It's true. Oh yeah, I'll try my new McLaren 12C out. What's that? Words hurt.
Where love hurts, love scars. Hurts.
Trying out my new McLaren 12C.
It's usually a very bounce car, you just sit in the middle of it.
Yeah.
Mid-engine. Man, I can't wait for Project Cars.
I gotta talk to them next week. Oh, that's right. I totally forgot to ask about that shit. Oh my god. This is my first time playing this track in rain, and it's my first time driving this car, folks, so be gentle.
You suck, man.
I do suck. You don't know this. Oh, shit!
They were telling us... What were you playing? They were telling us that we suck. Oh, Evolve, yeah.
Oh, Evolve. You're doing it wrong!
Well, we played some of the game, but I don't
know. That didn't do much for me.
Didn't make you randy.
Oh, fuck. Whoa! Wow, this car is squirrely.
Make sure you guys didn't turn your chat on from the stream. Did you? Very much.
Oh, shit.
No, you fucking cockbag.
Wow. Hi to you too, Ben.
I hit the wind and the guy just passed me. Oh, and hello.
Oh, crap.
Some of them are tracks.
I like them a lot.
Well, I was going to edit the podcast, but I said, fuck it. I need a race in Japan.
They don't have the events up yet, but you can do single events.
That's true. No, it's a two-hour podcast.
Of course, we don't want to have to get up front and talk about it.
Yeah. Jelly donuts and stuff.
This car is not performing this job.
Oh, that car in front of you. I fucking hate that vehicle.
Is that the
Ariel?
Ariel Adams?
No.
That thing's crazy.
Yeah, that car sucks. Oh, jeez. Really? 90 minutes to download this shit.
Yeah,
it might
like
speed up.
Gigs.
That's almost 6.
Hey, Vinny, you're supposed to come in the chat room and demand an apology from Glenn.
For what?
I got over it.
What I do now?
Remember that time Vlad, was it Johnny's friend that came and says, you owe me an apology, Johnny.
What?
Oh, was it Mo? Yeah.
Oh my god. Alright, let's take more seconds.
Podcast off. And
wait a night.
How big was your recording, Vinny?
Hold on. I'm just renaming y'all's podcast.
Like 700 or
something. Yours is 723. Mine's 723.
Okay.
Dave's is 73.
Yeah, Apple must really compress that shit.
Are you doing it wrong? But well, AIF is actually better than Wave. It's more efficient. So,
well, get this: like, me and Stoff's bitrate is 705, and Dave's is 71.
That'd be Dave's smaller.
Yeah, it has to be.
Dave's is smaller.
I need to, but I haven't been together.
That's what I've been saying for every week for 8 years.
Can you believe that bombshell you dropped? Wow.
What?
Remember Dave? Before we started recording? I think he left what he wasn't supposed to do.
What? He didn't talk about the game, did he?
No.
Mike?
Where he said, don't tell anybody.
Oh, yeah. I gotta edit that out, don't I?
Yeah. I don't know what you're recording,
man. Why are you gonna bring that up? Why are you gonna bring that up when our voices are being broadcasted over the stream?
Only mine.
Oh, yeah, I forgot.
I don't remember if we're recording or not.
we're clickbaiting y'all.
Yeah. Or PSNation.com for the story.
Yeah.
I don't remember if we were recording or not.
I listened to the podcast twice.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, you did already.
Yeah, and that, what I do is I, when all our tracks are separate, I'll go through and I'll mute stuff, you know, like a call for this or that. And then I export it as one file, and then I take out all the spaces. Like,
wow.
All the pauses and shit like that.
Way too much.
It works for me. It's just, it takes a long time, but it's just kind of one of those things that's like, I got my way of doing it.
Yeah, that won't last.
Yeah.
Well, it's not like we do it every week, so.
I used to take all of Josh's ums out, and that don't happen no more.
Well, we had some pretty, just kind of, I would get finished talking, and Dave and Soph were expecting me to say something else, and it's kind of like, yeah.
Because you talked
about it. Also, being there too, I think like 10 times in a row, we had to wrap it up.
Oh, yeah, that'll happen.
Well, the second time I go through, I don't listen as much. I just look at the timeline and say, oh, there's a moment of silence. I'm going to just knock that out. And, you know, it takes me about 30 minutes the second time around, whereas it'll take me 2 hours for the first time. What are we naming this one?
I just call it the Station Evolve.
Yeah, we didn't talk about Evolve that much. Actually, I think we talked a lot about H1Z1, a lot more than I was kind of expecting. So,
they're giving refunds for H1Z1?
Yeah, I heard about that. Which, I don't think people should ask for a refund right away if the game's in early access.
Look at this rain right now. I can't even see the road. It looks like it's just pooling. Jeez.
I think probably the first tower is all Destiny and
H1Z1. Mm-hmm. Oh, someone touched Destiny.
Not that anybody in this chat room listens to it, so.
Yeah.
I don't know the street codes either.
Sure.
I think it's fixed Driveclub issues, by the way.
What's that?
Oh, yeah. Thanks. I'm waiting. I'll do that. Where the hell's my captures?
Kershaw weather.
You know, if I was getting into a Ferrari when it was raining, I wouldn't sit there and look at the door for a couple seconds. I'd try to get in as fast as possible because I don't want to get the interior wet.
Well, interior that expensive. It's got to be rain resistant.
No, it's just that expensive because it has the word Ferrari sticked on it.
Oh, you dicks!
Makes it run
a chess simulation in the background.
Is that a 1 or a 0?
Get on the road.
Oh, I'll do that.
Jeez, this car. Wow.
How are you driving?
Ferrari FF, which I usually love, but man, it's just not doing well. Fighting it tooth and nail. GTA Driveclub.
You're Canadian. You're not supposed to be that angry.
Everybody owns a gun in Canada. Are you nuts? Gotta watch out for bear, eh?
Moose.
Those aggressive moose.
They can be, actually.
Oh, yeah.
They're beavers.
And from second to second.
Make a boo-boo.
I would hit Y to rewind, but I don't think there's a Y button on it.
Why not?
I don't know. Ah!
Maybe pick up your Xbox.
Yeah. I don't need my Xbox to control it, that might be. Wow, this car does not handle rain well. Gotta hype it.
Hype. Oh, I found one, Jesus.
Like...
Mama jokes. I'd like to delete, not to read.
Oop.
Jeez, Vinny, haven't got a club up to 30 yet? Jeez, slacker.
Yeah.
And I thought you were trying.
Oh.
Oh, if you beat Crota on the hard mode, you get his hand cannon.
Yeah.
Is that a good thing?
I guess. Impact is powerful. Reload is decent. Did you ever get the review codes, Torgo, for Far Cry 4 DLC?
No. I never expected it.
But they usually give them out for you guys?
Depends on the game. Well, if IGN demands it, it has to happen.
Yeah. You see someone's painting of, Colin Moriarty and Greg Miller?
No, were they in, like, bondage and everything?
They did their last episode today, and they're on a, like, a gold stallion shirt with soul ripped from each other.
They did their last episode.
Yeah. Well, one of their last, whatever, up at noon or whatever.
Yeah. Oh, that's right.
All ripped from each other.
Oh boy. The one of them had a ball gag in? Just curious.
I'm pretty sure.
No, they just...
No homo, though.
But that's the whole thing, like, they're taking that joke to the extreme and it's getting more creepy now.
Yeah, well, I think it's their way of coming out with them.
Yeah. Just sing the whole thing. We know you know it.
I actually don't know it. I didn't just sing a bit. No, I actually don't know the rest of it.
Sure you don't.
I'm more of an 80s.
So you like Wham? Game.
Yeah, I like Wham back then. Actually, I want to hear the new band with Andrew Ridgely and Oates. One night, one show. Oates and the other guy from Wham.
Oh, Wham.
Yeah.
That's
Andrew Ridgely was the other guy.
Whatever happened?
He married one of the chicks from Bananarama, and he's a race car driver. Oh, or he was. He started driving Formula Un. I think he married the blonde one.
Yeah, let me know before you go.
Wake me up before you go.
Wake me up. Oh, the 80s.
Oh, damn it. It's one problem with these AMG Mercedes. They make so much work.
Of course, you know, the only way you should listen to these ones.
Oh god.
There you go, Brian. Who do you rather listen to, Nickelback or Bon Jovi?
Nickelback.
Yeah.
I seriously. I hate Bon Jovi so much.
I liked Bon Jovi at the time. I never did.
I take Bon Jovi over Nickelback any day.
Nope.
I like Nickelback too much.
I'm gonna give that a big bit of man. Nope.
Wow, this car.
Got some aggressive drivers this time.
Yeah, they are.
I've got it on easy, too, just because I want to race, you know, and just have an easy going race. Dicks.
You have no problem even driving in the rain. Just slide around.
Oh, no, they're sliding around on mine. Oh, shit.
Oh, he just tried to pick me.
This was not prepared to pick! I recovered! God dang it. There goes the punishment. Holy shit!
Ugh. No, I'm reading forums about H1Z1. People bitching.
What a surprise, people bitching on the internet.
Let's say what? Wow, the rain's really coming down. Holy shit. Get on the road! I
think the guys driving these cars with these roads are driving with this weather. What a little air can be off.
I took the wrong car for sure. Trying to feather the accelerator and it's still just jamming me up.
All the water.
Yeah. This car's got too much torque for driving in the rain like this. Like even on the straightaway, it's tough to keep it straight. It just gets squirrely.
Probably in a gay little car.
Yeah,
that for straight. Oh. That's
what's
actually blocking me. Wow.
Oh, yeah. Ah!
Oh, then he undercut me with his.
I had one brake check me before.
It wasn't me. Oh, it was me. It was a black
dude on TF2. Oh, Vinny did it to me, didn't he?
Vinny?
No, it wasn't me.
It was a Brambler. Brambler did it.
Brake checking me, you ass?
Yep, and he's like,
yeah, that was me. I think it was in the last.
There's the double rainbow.
We played. Wait, there's a double rainbow in that game?
There's a double rainbow.
Oh my god. 23 more minutes. I can get my double rainbow.
Fine, CNB Crumb.
He's like, who are you guys?
Fucking don't come back. Jeez. Ooh, I unlocked the Ferrari F12 Berlinetta. Nice.
Sounds like a gun.
Oh, it's a nice car.
You guys weren't talking about the Oats and Andy show, were you?
No, I was talking about... Oh, who did the joke?
Andrew Ridgeway or Ridge whatever and John Oates. That's fucking funny, dude.
No, there was a comedian years ago. God darn it. I can't remember who it was, but he said, I'd go see that show. One night, one show. Oates and the other guy from Wham. I don't remember who it was anymore, though. It might have been...
Oh.
It's on the tip of my tongue, and I can't think of who it is.
Just look down, you'll see it.
Yeah.
Got to see Patton Oswalt last week. He was great. He's got a good hour
nice. Going. Nice.
No, Patton Oswalt.
He's awesome.
He's geek smart.
Oh, yeah. All right, where's this Berlinetta at? Isn't it super?
His first book is hilarious, too.
I think it'd be a sport.
Is that the movie one?
That's the one that just came out. The first book was called Zombie Spaceship Wasteland.
Oh, yeah. I'll try this in my new car. His bit on the prequels is pretty damn funny.
You're talking about the Eric Blevins thing?
About getting in a time machine and finding George Lucas or whatever? Oh, yeah. A really annoying time.
I had friends at the time of that first film coming out. They were big Star Wars fans, and they had to pick up what I ended up calling big fans. Big fans of the picture of the film. That's a big one. Yeah, I got sick big fans, you know? Yes, yes, I'm a big fan. And then they asked me to get it. If you see a copy of the Rolling Stone magazine with Jar Jar on the cover, grab it.
Oh.
I'll tell you what happened. I hadn't read Rolling Stone in a long time. I picked up that issue and I started reading this Tom Waits piece in it. And the writing style was just driving me out of my skull. The writers seem to be all copying each other.
Yeah. And then you find out Tom Waits actually wrote it himself.
Yeah, probably.
I like this car. Oh! Oh, shit, 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 shit! Actually go on the main interface and go to what's new, and it should show that your friend is broadcasting and you should take your way to it. Well, it should just pop right up. You shouldn't even have to look at my name. It should just say a friend is broadcasting. Yeah. And it should
showing that it was the last game you were playing the ball. I was showing me the ball.
Oh, yeah, from yesterday. Shit, 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 shit! Yeah, it shows you a preview, and then you can say go to live from PlayStation. It goes right from there to my channel.
Well, when I go live from PlayStation, it says broadcast stop.
Well, you can't do the Evolve one. You have to refresh that what's new. Because it's trying to take you to the one from yesterday. Oh, okay. Yeah, if you find that one and do go to life from PlayStation, it'll take you right there. You can do a search on my name, just put Torgo in there and should find it.
Yeah, that's just that. they're playing number four.
Something's going on, man. I am. I like that car. Oof. The new Ferrari I just opened? That's a nice car. Torgo likes it.
Awesome.
Jesus Christ. So, if I go to live, I get jump. Did you write Japan style? Is that?
New tracks Japan, but Japan's in parentheses.
No, it's not giving me that one. I'm only giving one.
Go to buy game and look up Driveclub.
That's what I'm looking at. I'm looking at all the Driveclub feeds. I'm getting 14 feeds.
Hmm.
But
and mine's not on there? That's kind of weird.
The username that is connected. Tell me who the username is. Some people have typed their username in there.
I'm not sure.
Driving the club. I want to go fast. New tracks. Is that it? I want to go fast.
New tracks.
Actually, I think Twitch is messing up too because I'm trying to reload it and it's taking forever. Yeah, I think something's going on at Twitch. I don't know. I don't know what to tell you.
Yeah, I didn't like your name. Now I'm live from PlayStation. I'm on the PS4.
Probably working the Vita one. That's pretty good on the Vita. No, I have a feeling it's probably something on Twitch or something. It's working now, but it's giving some problems. God dang it. Cool, like if the little cherry blossoms run around and they go through them and pick them up. Oh my gosh.
Next gen, yo!
Your microphone on those headphones just must be like ultra sensitive. Damn, I always screw this corner up. What's that?
Right, that one word or two?
One.
Don't forget the hashtag.
ass dead, you forget your ass dead right here.
That's fine.
That's the black guy in his underwear.
Yep. All my bitches dancing around me.
Yeah. I think what's that guy?
A couple more races and I gotta run. I gotta get some D before we record.
His name's M&M, but he actually spells it M and M.
Yeah, we're in a copyright dispute on that right now. I think I found a loophole.
Yeah.
Oh well, I'll have to go back and watch it on the PC, I guess. Because that shite ain't waking.
Weird.
Should be able to search by not just Torgo, but by PS Nation over on the Twitch feed.
No, you can't search on Live with PlayStation. You can't search for the channel name.
Huh, okay.
Now I'm curious. I'm going to try to pull it up on mine quick.
You're coming through fine on the PC. Not a problem. Except for that buzz screen chat.
There we go. Come on, load up.
That sure is a pretty like.
Okay. Search. T-O-R-G-O. Nope. Oh, because it wants keywords. Interesting.
Yeah, keyword drive club doesn't get it either, oddly enough. I tried, and I just started giving it instructions like, you know, lick my nuts because you're pissing me off, and it didn't give me anything there either.
That didn't work either? Let's see here. Yeah, I don't know. Weird. All right. All right, so that's the track in reverse. Do I have to do it in reverse gear? Cars.
Oh, yeah.
Vinny's going to Japan. Take it easy. All right, take it easy. Shit.
So, you like this first-person view? Is there an option to use up the views?
Yep, you just hit R1. I've shown this before too. I just don't like driving like this. It drives me nuts.
Oh, there it is.
get there.
Well, that's where you got the rear view mirror. See, if you do the other view, I don't think you get a rear view mirror, though. That's one. I don't know, this one just works for me. Oh, shit!
I like the third person view.
Hey, why is it that cars in Grand Theft Auto games do not have speedometers? There's no indication how fast you're going. This seems like a simple thing to put in.
Because I don't think they want that to be the focus, they just want you to drive. It's not meant to be realism, it's just another conveyance. Yeah. Oh yeah.
Oh my god.
Boy, did I screw that one up.
Oh, Mario, I've only been racing on Japan for like 10 seconds.
Yeah.
And I'm already in love with these tracks.
Yeah, I like them.
Man, boy.
Yep.
The more I watch you race, Torgo, I'm sorry to say, the better I feel about my own crappy racing skills.
Yeah.
That sounds actually, like you're one-on-one race.
He's at least three notches above me. I'm not a racing guy. I cannot play race games. I hate them. They make me grind my teeth in my sleep.
Let's try with this roof.
I got so upset with Mod Nation Racers that I damn near just cracked the disc in half.
Well, Mod Nation's not really a racer, though. Kart racers are very different. Because you're worried more about the weapons and everything else.
I couldn't get anywhere in the campaign because I couldn't win the third or fourth race because they kept rubber banding this guy up my butt.
Yeah, it's funny because they kept saying there's no rubber banding in it, and I actually called the guy a couple days after I had the game, and I'm like, bullshit if this game doesn't have any rubber banding.
And it was a deal breaker.
Yeah, I still really like that game, mainly for the online. Oh yeah, well, everybody got up in arms about that, because they had to have something to complain about.
Thank you. I can't see bitching about road cars. You want to do like Xbox used to do, and get up and change the disc 4 times for your game?
Oh shit, 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 shit! That came out of nowhere.
I like this next to me.
Oh, fuck.
Got you one of them hard fans coming up.
Yeah.
Isn't helping, they're slamming in the back of
that. I can see. Go next.
Get the lights moving, yeah.
See, in there, green or grease.
How about a
red? Ah, yeah.
You dick.
You're a dick.
Rocket Torgo, rocket.
You're a dick. Man, this dude just ran up and tried to...
That's what I think about you, dick.
Whoa.
You're just a big slimy dude.
Oh yeah. Something.
They're called pheromones.
Ugh. It's all bleachy and creepy.
I made pheromones.
That's how I got my wife.
I thought you told her that you were gonna inherit a bunch of money when you were 50 and. No, really, I'm gonna inherit a ton of money. $26.48. Yeah, which just dropped to $2.50 right now. Oh, God, this car. Why'd I pick a hypercar, damn it?
Get hyped.
You ought to work on the, make a new car paint job thingy.
Yeah, when I get time.
Good time. Do it while you're broadcasting.
Yeah, while we're recording. We're not going to broadcast tonight. Because I haven't really had time to work on what I need to fix on the broadcast if I'm hanging out. It did, but I want to get it so that it changes the camera automatically, and I want to get it for the chat to work better and all that shit. Well, people were commenting, but it wasn't a live chat. Yeah, people were commenting. I was getting an email every time they commented, but because it was using YouTube and YouTube. Yeah, YouTube doesn't do chat; it does comments. And it's stupid. So I still gotta figure that stuff out.
Skin pro guy, get him.
Trying. Third.
Flat his tires.
Fuck! Car's a newsie when you need one.
See?
So much violence.
See the violence inherent in the system? I'm being repressed! I'm being repressed!
We're an autonomous collective.
Alright, one more race, and then I'm gonna go get dinner.
So you say you are not going to try and broadcast on the Hangout tonight, or you are?
No, I don't think we're going to try it tonight.
Aww.
That's okay. We'll get to hear the cast tomorrow.
Yeah, because I got to... Well, Josh wanted to record tomorrow morning. I'm like, if we do it, we have to do it early, because I have to get to Oshkosh and get settled, because I start my new job on Wednesday.
Hey, good luck on the new gig.
Thanks. GTL, huh?
Just tell them that you know the people on the sideshow.
Yep.
But I already have the job. I don't want to lose it.
Why are you so mean to us? We're just trying.
Why can't you just love us? For fuck's sake.
I don't love anything. Apparently, I don't have the capacity to be loved, so I can't reciprocate.
Well, staying at home playing video games doesn't get you love unless it's Lara Croft.
Yeah, well. My problem is I go to the wrong bars, too. I can't go to the hippity-hip, you know.
Well, yeah, it's all full of guys.
You need to be visiting the bike club in the manhole, okay?
Yeah. I'll just go back to San Francisco for GDC and stay across from Stud right. Again. I'm so proud of that on Instagram, and nobody even responded to it. I'm like, oh, I wanted to play Hold'em, too. Because it works on a couple levels, and I loved it.
Right after Hurricane Katrina hit, we were in the hotel room, and me and his boat captain were.
Oh, boy.
And
well,
the company was paying for the room, and then they didn't tell us, and the guys just said, hey, the company stopped paying for the hotel room, y'all gotta get out. So he got pissed off because, man, fuck this shit, I'm going to fall. So he goes to just a random bar down the French Quarter, and he gets in, he gets his Budweiser, and he's drinking it, and he sees these two guys over there that are just talking, doing their thing. And he noticed on the wall it's nothing but posters of guys in their underwear. And he's like, oh lord, I'm in the wrong bar. When he walked out, he looked at the name of the bar. It's called the Corner Pocket.
Just thought it was a pool hall. When we were in, I probably told Stoff and Vinny this story, but when I went to Europe back in 2013. We went to Brussels for the last couple days because we were flying out of Brussels, and we just decided we'll drop off the car, stay down in the Centrum, and, you know, just walk around and go to Delirium Cafe and everything. Well, our buddy Jeff had gotten in early, and he was hanging around in Brussels when before Paul and I got there, and we're like walking around, and he's like, listen, there's this one little pub that I kept walking by, and it always looked so charming and everything, but there were always people, like, even outside, because there was a soccer match on, and it was like overflowing out into the sidewalk. And he goes, so do you mind if we stop there? I'm like, yeah, let's do it, you know. And me and Paul were like, yeah. So we go in, and it's a really neat little place, like, just a lot of character, really, really old, you know, and just really nice place, and the prices were just amazing as usual. And we sit down, we have a couple beers, and, you know, just had a couple beers and had a good time, and we decided we're going to go to another place. So one of the guys goes up to pay, and I go outside, and here they find out the owner is actually from America, so they're talking to him for a few minutes, and I'm outside, and I had a weird vibe in the place, but I had my back to everything. We were back in the corner, and I was looking at the wall, but there was a vibe I was getting, and it didn't bother me. It just, I had a vibe. So I go outside, and I'm standing there waiting for him to come out, and they're taking a couple minutes, and all of a sudden I look up, rainbow flag. So whatever. I mean, I've been to gay bars before. I don't give a shit. So they come out and
bars, actually.
What's that?
There's some of the funner bars to go to.
Well, this was really, no, this was very conservative. Like, you know, we walk in, there's an old guy sitting in the corner reading a newspaper, you know, and just very low key, you know, and
European chill.
Yeah. So we go outside, and I see the rainbow flag, and I start laughing because the two guys I'm with, I think they would freak out if they found out, you know, that sort of thing.
You never told them?
So, oh no. So they come out, and they're going, yeah, the owner's from America, and he was really nice, and he said, we're welcome back anytime, and blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, yeah, that makes sense. And they're like, what's that supposed to mean? And I pointed up at the flag. Now, both of these guys live in Madison, Wisconsin, the most liberal and, like, most progressive city in the state. I point up at this flag, and they both go, what's that mean? And I told them, like, it's a gay bar. What? No! So we get back to the room, and they look it up. And it's apparently, like, at night, it's apparently, like, a bear bar, even.
Oh, there you go, dude.
But it was so funny because it was just so chill when we were in there. I liked it. I would have gone back any time, you know?
I'm going out, boys. I'm hunting bear.
You guys gets up at 3 in the morning to sneak out of the room. Where are you going? I'm going to get a beer.
Yeah, I'm going to go get a beer. Wow, who's listening to the really loud music in the background? Holy shit.
Looks like Logic, maybe?
Oh, you're playing the Blue Oyster song.
Oh, shit. Logic's still here.
Well, the funny thing was, then we went to the Delirium Cafe on the second to last day, and that's where I stayed for like 12 and a half hours straight. I was drinking 9% to 15% beer all day for like 12 and a half hours. I was having a blast, you know. And I get back to the hotel at like 4 in the morning and woke up at 7, and I was still drunk off my butt. And my buddies are like, we're gonna go to breakfast. I'm like, I need to sleep. I am drunk. So they come back to the room after, and I'm still drunk. I wasn't hungover. I was drunk. And they're like, we're gonna go back to that one place. I'm like, what? I go, the gay bar? And they're like, yeah. I go, all right. Well, no, it just, for those guys, I just never expected it with all the bars around there. We're gonna go back to the gay bar. So, but I slept. I was so drunk that day. So then we went out that night, and I finally had a couple more beers, and I'm like, we gotta get up early and catch the train to the airport and all that. But yeah. Well, maybe. But none of that was happening there. It was just so conservative in the place. It was weird. Like, it's almost like you go into one of those old-timey places where everybody's got, like, a big burly mustache and a monocle, you know, that sort of place. Just, oh, yes, quite, you know. But here it's a gay bar. It was just weird.
So you don't remember the name of the gay bar, though, huh?
No, I'm sure I have it somewhere, but because I know they looked it up. Well, that place is amazing. It's 11 different bars now, but it's in the Guinness Book of World Records as having the most beers. They have over 2,000 beers. Well, the original one's in a basement, and then they've been buying up all the other bars around there. And, shit.
They've got a store there, too.
Yeah, well, their menu is like a book. It's 10 euro to buy the menu even, just for the drinks, or for the beers. And then, so we hung out in the one in the basement. Well, that place is kind of considered a sort of mecca for beer drinkers anyway. All of Belgium is, but Delirium Cafe is really famous. So we were in there, and it was half Americans. I mean, we were just... And we were there before tourist season at all the other places, so we didn't really have... It was great because we got to go anywhere we wanted, but at the same time, there was no interaction, really, for the whole 12 days we were there. So... My buddies were, they got drunk pretty quickly, and they're like, we're going to go. I'm like, nah, I'm staying. I said, I'm having a blast, you know, and I was hanging out with this surfer guy from Hawaii and this couple from New York City. I mean, I was just having a great old time. And...
Did he have surfer abs?
Did what?
The surfer had surfer abs.
Oh, he was pretty ripped. He was a really nice guy. He was a little bit older, too, but he was like a... He's been on ESPN and everything. No. No. So, it was great because the bartenders barely spoke English, but they just took a shine to me. And actually to me and my buddies, because we were just so enthusiastic about, like, about Goose and some other some other beers a lot of people don't go for. And like, at one point, we were going to order this anniversary one, and he goes, actually, I've got this better one in the back. He goes, it's not even on the menu. He goes, I got one bottle left. He goes, I'll bring it out. So he brought it out. I mean, it was just outstanding stuff. And, like, bottles like this, probably 30, 40 bucks in the U.S. It was, like, 10 bucks.
The big
Oh, yeah, the big 750-milliliter bottles, and, yeah.
Oh.
Oh, yeah, it was fucking insane. I mean... I don't even drink beer that much. It's hilarious. I'm just not a big beer drinker because it fills me up. But in Europe, oh my God. Like, I was just in heaven. I was just... We stayed at two different breweries on our trip. And we had all the place to ourselves pretty much. Yeah. No, they had bed and breakfast. But, oh God, it was so much fun. We met some just awesome people, too.
Reminds me of going to New Orleans a lot. We used to live in Alabama. We spent our weekends in New Orleans, and we always ran into Australians, yeah. French people. You know, very few Americans partying at the Coops and all those little joints my buddy knew about.
Yeah.
Great little dives.
I don't think I could ever go to New Orleans because Vinny used to live there.
The company I worked at, we would always pick up guys off the ships. And,
yeah, I bet you did.
We'd bring them to shore so they could go out on the town, and then when they come back to the to the docks, and we'd go drive them back to the ship.
Hmm.
That's cool. Yeah, you go nuts out on a fucking rig, or a ship, or whatever.
And they had one guy. They had these. It was a group of guys. No, I would just ride the boat. I was a deckhand.
Shit.
These guys, they went out, we picked them up around 6, and they came back around 2 in the morning, and they had this camera, they picked up a hooker somewhere, and they were showing pictures of them fucking her all sorts of ways.
Oh, jeez.
They were like, we were going, that's cool, man. Dude, get these motherfuckers out of our dock. I heard the story of that same boat captain that went to the gay bar. When he was a deckhand, he went onto an Egyptian ship, and the captain was asking about Viagra. And he goes, "Oh man, you gonna go pick up a woman tonight?" He goes, "No, I have cabin boy. I fucking ass tonight."
Oh boy.
He's like, Jesus Christ.
Come right out in a minute, dude. Yeah. I am gay, actually, and I went to a party with some Liberians a couple nights ago up in Philadelphia.
Yeah.
This guy I worked with was Liberian, and all her friends. There were like 50 people in this party, live music, DJ on the computer, in the basement and live. It was weird. It was like kind of a jazz, kind of a Fela like Hootie thing going on in the live band. And, DJ.
Did you say a Hootie thing?
No, Fela runs some of Hootie.
Oh, okay. I thought you said, like, hooting the blowfish or something. Like, ugh. That'd turn any man straight.
I was born in the 60s, man. I'm all about Led Zeppelin and that shit.
Yeah.
You won't catch me listening to Hootie and the Blowfish.
Come on, man. Anyway, crack your window.
Crowd and these Liberian people all speak this patois. So I'm having a blast because I love etymology. I'm trying to pick up on what everybody's saying. It was fantastic.
Nice.
Left about 5 in the morning.
Oh shit, oh shit. Oh, this Ferrari is a little bit tougher to drive. I got the GTO out.
Yeah, it's a lot of torque. It's long.
Yeah.
Oh man, these tracks are so pretty.
Oh.
Yeah.
I just like them because they're not as, well, except for this section, they're not as curvy. It allows you to kind of race, you know?
See more.
Yeah. Oh shit.
I wish they would do, like, do y'all remember from Gran Turismo 3, the test track? It was just a giant circle where you could get hit, like, top speed or mini car. I wish they would put one of those in here.
Yeah. Oh, alright, stream, I'm stopping.
Remember the one from 4 that was like a, almost like a paperclip, but it was really long?
I never played 4. I never played it.
Oh, 4 was phenomenal. Nice. Oh, putting a 1080p, or 1080i.
I would always get one Gran Turismo 4.